Hello everyone, welcome back to PGA Chain Design. Halloween season is coming, so let's take a look on how to make this pumpkin shape. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to start making some bump. Of course, you can kind of draw whatever bump that you like, which it's not symmetrical. So the way I will do is I will use the star and snapping into the zero, making the corner of a star number for 10, and you can do any size that you want and have them to come back. Once we have that, we need to have the corner to be rounded. So let's use the fitted corners, and we can fit it this one. Let's set it up for radius for 2 and see how we like it. At this point, you can kind of make it not as symmetrical because it's organic shape, and you can have one is bigger or smaller or whatever that you like to change. After that, we are going to make a copy by 3D scale the gumball, and then we wanted to make a copy by clicking the Alt key. Alright, so the things that we have is we have one, the big one is right in the middle, and depends on how tall your pumpkin is going to be. I draw the other one over there. So the pumpkin is coming outline is like this bumpy, and but when it comes into the center, we want it to be nice and smooth. So right here, I'm going to draw a circle and bring the circle in a little bit. What I mean a little bit in is this shape is coming over here and kind of cave in. To make it symmetrical, I'm going to have this one mirror to the other side. So we're gonna use the command called loft. We're gonna pick in the order, go to 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Go to the top view and double make sure everybody is aligned. So we want to make sure that everybody's snapping into the quadrant. Otherwise, the pumpkin surface will be twist. All right, let's take a look on this one. All right, so if everything's look nice to you, you can just click OK. Then we already have this shape here. You can simply just use the cap to cap the opening so it will be closed over there. Okay, so I'm going to lock this one and just using this curve. For this curve, I'm gonna scale it down a little bit and making a copy. Make sure it's still snapping into the center, so let's use a line tool and snapping into the centers. So this is where the button is going to be, and once it's coming out, I will like it coming back to the circle. So on the top, it's going to be a circle. So you're going to see something like this, have this moving to the top. Now, if we look at the curve right here, this curve that we have, if we want to rebuild, we need to make sure it's degree 3, and we're going to make it into 24, and let's click OK. Make sure the top one is a degree 3 too. So then we have the same point, two curve over there. That's using the commands called loft, and we're going to loft again from here to here, and make sure they are aligned to the quadrant, or somewhere close to the quadrant. So this is the surface that we get, and it's a single surface. That means we can turn on the control point. So in order to have more control point, I want to insert somewhere on the bottom over here, somewhere on the bottom over here, and somewhere at the neck over here. And then let's take a look what we can do. At the front view, we're going to turn on the control point, and I want this one to be scaled down a lot so we can get that beautiful neck over there. And maybe we're gonna lower down this one and make them a little bit bigger so we can kind of getting the shape like this. Right over here, we might also want to get it smaller and smaller. So you're kind of getting this like neck-ish looking shape, and you can do whatever change that fitting into your design. We can also turn them in the angle. So we might want to kind of turn them like this, and this seems sitting a little bit too low. So let's bring it up a little bit. And once you like it, you can go ahead and cap it. Let's go ahead to take a look on the render view. All right, so give a very nice bumpy shape over there. And once you assign the material, and that will be what it looks on the rendering. I would like to give it a special thanks to Carl Brophy. Thank you for your generous donation to my channel that will help me to improve the channel content and helping more people. I'm so excited because this is my first donation that I've received from the channel. So thank you. And thank you for everybody for your watching. Please like and comment and share mine so I can reach more people who want to learn Rhino. Thank you, and I'll see you next.